Dear students, I am your English teacher, Shahadat Islam. How are you? I hope you are well, but it seems to me you are not so well because you are missing the practical classes, you are missing us, you are missing your friends, you are missing everything. That is why it seems to me you are not in a sound mind. You know that at present the world is going through a great crisis. And one thing you should remember that this kind of unexpected situation comes in our life. But we have to overcome that. We have to go forward. Due to this coronavirus, due to this unexpected situation, all the classes have been suspended for a long time and our school remains closed. We have to fight against this virus. But we cannot hamper our study. We need to continue our study. You know that our government is very much concerned about your problem. Our government has taken a very time demanding initiative. Our government has instructed us to continue our academic activities through online classes. That is why I am here with the online classes. So you all are welcome to my online classes. In my last class, you requested me to take a class on transformation of sentence. Today I am going to give you an idea about transformation of sentence. But you know that transformation of sentence is a vast item. I cannot make it clear. I cannot teach you everything in a single class. I need some more classes to make you understand or to give you idea about transformation of sentence. So, transformation of sentence. Before giving you idea about transformation of sentence, we need to understand what is close and what is a sentence. What is the difference between a close and a sentence? You need to take clear idea about the close. I am trying to give you an idea about the close by giving you some examples. Dear students, look at the board. What I am doing now, I am taking the class, or I am teaching you. You know that it is a sentence. You are following me. It is another sentence. I am teaching you. It's a sentence. You are following me. It is also a sentence. But if I connect the two sentences by conjunction and, you can see now it is not a sentence. I am teaching you, it has become a part of a sentence. So I am teaching you, it is a clause. You are following me, it is a clause. I am teaching you, it is a part of a sentence. You are following me, it is a part also. I am teaching you and you are following me. It's a sentence. But I am teaching you, it is a clause. You are following me, it is also a clause. So, what is a clause? I can define it in such a way. एक वॉस इज ए पार्ट ऑफ ए लार्जर सेंटेंस हैविंग ए सब्जेक्ट एंड ए वर्ब. What is a clause? A clause is a part of a sentence. Here I am teaching you. It is a part of a larger sentence. So I am teaching you. It is a clause. You are following me. It is also a clause. So I can define it such a way. A clause is a part of a larger sentence having a subject and a verb. And you know that you have idea about sentence. What is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words which is organized in a certain order and makes a complete sense. That is called sentence. But a clause is a part of a larger sentence having a subject and a verb. A clause can be mainly of three kinds. A clause can be mainly of three kinds. Principal clause, then subordinate clause. Then coordinate clause. Clause can be mainly of three kinds: principal clause, subordinate clause, and coordinate clause. I am trying to make you a clear idea about three kinds of clause by giving you some examples. Principal clause, a clause which is independent and on which a subordinate clause depends is called the principal clause. What is a principal clause? A clause which is independent. And on which a subordinate clause depends is called the principal clause. If you study regularly, you can make a It's a principal clause. If you study regularly, you can make a good result. The meaning of this clause is not dependent on this clause. The meaning of this clause is independent. It has expressed an independent meaning. So this is principal clause. Now I am trying to give you idea about subordinate clause. What is subordinate clause? A clause which is dependent on the principal clause is called the subordinate clause. What is a subordinate clause? A clause which is dependent on the principal clause is called the subordinate clause. I am giving you an example now. Unless you study regularly, you cannot make a good result. It's a subordinate clause. Unless you study regularly, you cannot make a good result. What is the condition? Listen to me. What is the condition? Give your attention. You cannot make a good result. So, what is the condition of make a good result? You will have to study. And unless you study regularly, you cannot make a good result. So, you need to study regularly for making a good result. The meaning of this clause is dependent on that clause. Then comes what is coordinate clause. A sentence which has two principal clauses is called a A sentence which has two principal clauses is called a coordinate clause. He worked hard, but could not shine in life. He worked hard but could not shine in life. He worked hard, it's a principal clause. Could not shine in life, it's a principal clause. So it's a coordinate clause. It seems to me you have taken a clear idea about three clauses. Today you are given idea about three kinds of clauses. In the next class, I shall discuss about sentences, simple, complex and compound sentences. Before ending the class, I would like to say something. Dear students, you know that at present we are passing a very dangerous time. We are passing a crisis. We are passing a hard time actually. So, unnecessarily you should not go outside. But if you have to go outside, you will go outside wearing a mask. So, thank you very much and I will request you to follow my next class. I am going to stop here.